a wall of noise greets the players as they emerge into this wonderful arena. Led out by the Malaysians Ong Yu Sin and Tiu Yi. Came through a wonderful match yesterday against the World Championship silver medalists Astrup and Rasmussen. So an eagerly anticipated quarter-final. This will be a 10th meeting between these two pairs, and of the previous nine, Hoki and Kobayashi won 7 of them, but it was the Malaysians who won the last, which was the semi-final of last year's Badminton Asia Championships in Dubai.
You on the toss.
Ong and Tio ended up losing the final, having beaten their opponents in the semi-final stage. So there were silver medalists at the Asia Championships, losing out in the final to Ranking Reddy and Shetty, who incidentally are on the adjoining court in their quarter-final right now. Well, as far as the Japanese pair are concerned, they're going to be looking to reach their third quarter-final in 3 years at this event. But Ong Yu Sin, who will turn 29 later this month from the ancient city of Malacca, he and his partner are in their third quarter-final in 3 years. They'll be looking to reach a first-ever semi-final at their home event. Tui Yi is 30 years of age from Muar in Johor. And they are 12 on the world ranking at the moment, but did spend 6 weeks at their career high of number 6. That was from the 6 month last year. There was an awful lot of sixes there, weren't there? Now I was telling you about that match against the World Championship silver medalist Astrup and Erasmus, and they came from 7-12 down in the deciding game before winning it 24-22 in an hour and a minute. It was absolutely thrilling. This is Takuro Hoki. He is 28 years of age from Yamaguchi. And he and his partner are one of 3 former champions that started this year's championship in men's doubles draw. His left-handed partner is also 28 years of age. He's from Miyagi. And that's the east coast of Honshu. Former world number ones, former world champions, and former champions here at the Malaysian Open. They beat the Olympic champions in the first round, Li Yang and Wang Qilin, and then beat the European Championship silver medalists, Alexander Dunn and Adam Hall. Our court officials for this one, Vishwanath from Sri Lanka and Sindberg from Denmark. Well, it's been 10 years since the Malaysian pair was in the final of the Malaysian Open, and how dearly the home fans would love to see one of the two Malaysian pairs in the quarterfinal stage go all the way to Sunday's final. And in fact, at the mean opposite end of the draw, we could theoretically have an all-Malaysian men's doubles final, but there's an awful long way to go before that happens.
There is.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Takuro Hoki and Yuko Kobayashi, Japan. And on my left, Ong Yu Sin and Tio Yi, Malaysia. Tio Yi is 12 you've got Kobayashi level play.
So the Malaysians in the white shirts, the far end of the court, unseeded Ong Yu Sin and Tiu Yi Yi against the former champions Hoki and Kobayashi. Well, I don't think playing against a left and right handed combination is going to be any problem for the Malaysians, because this is the third consecutive right and left handed pair they've played against. Lu Chin Yao and Yang Po Han in the first round, and then Astra from Rasmussen in the second.
Low.
That's not. Can't happen that often that you play against three pairs consecutively that are a left and a right hander. Oh, he read that. Oh, it's long, though.
Service over. 1-2.
Displayed here at the early stages, Yugo Kobayashi sent to Yi totally in the wrong direction.
Yeah, was sharp onto that too.
3-on.
Well, the Japanese pair, one of two pairs from Japan to win the men's doubles title at the Malaysian Open. The other pair was in 2018, Komura and Sonoda. Ooh, string's gone in Kobayashi's racket. Yeah, he was just hiding at the front of the court, wasn't he?
5-4.
I think he probably actually said to his partner, it's up to you.
Where they defeated the Olympic champions Wang Qilin and Li Yang, and I said at that match that I felt the playing conditions here were Hoki style, but it all depended on what edition of Yugo Kobayashi we saw, and we saw an absolute magnificent Yugo Kobayashi in that match. Oi!
Well, he wasn't too shabby there either.
No,
was
exactly. So here we have a match with two magnificent front court players, Tiwi Yi and Takuro Hoki. And I think the Malaysians got to make sure they sort of remain on top of Takuro Hoki.
6-6.
And that puts a lot of pressure on Tiwi Yi to try and take command of the front court. He did that so well yesterday against the Danes.
Oh, brilliant. Hoki. Sees they're out of position. That was very calmly played.
And trick shots we've seen already.
Challenge unsuccessful.
One judge got it right.
One challenge remaining. Service over. 9-7. Play.
Always pull the fault.
Too high. No, he called fault. Service over. 8-9.
Head control, playing the round the head shot with a fairly big swing, and yet plays the delicate block. Look at that.
He knows that Kobayashi is going to go on the outer side of Tiu. That's the only reason why he's standing so far to the left for a Hoki.
So on a run of three straight points.
Same play.
Yeah.
11-9.
Well, make that a run of four straight points. There's the block from Kobayashi. Big gap across courts. and calmly found the open space to Kuro Hoki. So it's a 2-point advantage for the former champions, Hoki and Kobayashi.
Players back onto the court. Horn and Tio back onto the court. Eleven, nine, play.
Well, the first thing the Malaysians need to do is stop this run of points. And that's not helping their cause. It's now five straight points.
12-9.
Hoki and Kobayashi. He's already got strapping 13, on that right knee.
10. Maybe just landed a little bit awkward. 2.
Japanese pair just getting through on their attack.
Yeah, they're getting through on their attack, and they've got their game going. Both players, they were a little bit reluctant in the opening stage, like they didn't really know what was facing them. But like I said, this is Hoki conditions, fast playing conditions. Normally he's not that big of a hitter, so he can. Oh, there's a challenge here. So you can try and pin him to the background, get him away from the net, but that's not possible here. And they're just playing well, both the Japanese players. The Malaysian combination, very dependent on having Tiwi Yi at the front court. And when you know that, then you can say a lot of what type of shots are going to come in different situations.
Good interception. Good reading of the return by Kobayashi.
He had a service error. Did he have more than one service error, Kobayashi?
No, both of the Japanese players have had one service error.
Apart from that, he's served really well.
Yeah, I'll make it again. And it is awfully difficult on the defence from the near side of the court to control the lifts. And the Malaysians really need to be capitalising on that by getting down as much as possible. Sin's perspective.
17-13.
Racket had been down by his ankles, though. No wonder it was difficult to time that shot. As soon as you played one shot, the racket's got to be up ready for the next.
Service over, 14-17.
Thank you.
Well, he was trying to play it to cross court, that was obvious, but of course that would have come up to Kobayashi's forehand. That's a set play by the Japanese pair.
Great speed and their movement, the two with the yellow shoes.
Yeah, it's a super serve, isn't it? Really.
And that means that he can sort of be totally upright and cover, help cover the third shot, Kobayashi. Often very successful. Seems like sometimes they forget that he's left-handed.
A game, Kobayashi,
20 game
and
point.
It is 5 game point opportunities for the former champions, Hoki and Kobayashi.
Match won by Cosmic Silas Nagirati and Clark Setting, 21-11, 21-8.
Goes wide and the opening game in favour of the former world champions and the winners here 2 years ago. Takura Hoki and Yugo Kobayashi. Opening game 21-15 in 18 minutes.
And Chiu Yi has called for a medical.
Thank you.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds. Left back on the court. Pure back on the court. Left it back on the court.
Well, it was very concerning hearing that two-minute timeout because the medic was on to see long right knee. I think he's definitely strapping off that right knee.
He's taking it off.
Anyway, it appears okay to continue, which is jolly good news for us. But the Japanese pair, Hoki and Kobayashi, one game to the good.
One.
Alongside the court.
One,
getting the better of Ong and Tiu there. Have to be careful pushing. Simply can't get it below the tape. And he's able to play the third shot downwards.
Over 4-3.
Little deception on the lift there from Yugo Kobayashi. Great to see it in replay. This brings Olsen a little bit off balance. Takuro Hoki to Fake Ong Yusin. Have to lunge on the right knee. And a fantastic playing move, the two Japanese players. Six of the last 7 points. Champions.
They really are
three.
Rotating well, aren't they, the Japanese?
They are. This is sort of like, yeah. Sometimes in a double, could be mixed doubles. Mixed doubles could be mixed doubles. Sometimes you feel that, okay, there's two players playing a double. And sometimes it all melts together and it becomes one unity that plays a double. That's just wonderful to watch when it happens.
Yeah. So another challenge from Hoki and Kobayashi. Yeah, and they were right again.
Correction out. 9
3 In the meantime, TVU was play. Out conferring with the Malaysian coaches, Rosman Rasak, one of them, that's what to do. They lost 9 of the last 10 points now.
Yeah, super. Yeah, it really had to be a winner there from Hoki because his partner's racket had broken. Yeah, racket's swings went. And it was a wonderful interception, an even better angle from Tokoro Hoki. Ten of 11 points now. Thank you, Steve. Thank you for reminding me.
Oh, that was steep.
Yeah,
wonderful smash.
And to the mid-game interval. With an 11-4 advantage. Be awfully difficult for the Malaysians to turn this around. Mind you, they came from 7-12 down in the deciding game yesterday to win the match. Anything is possible.
Four one, 20 seconds.
Well, Tang Kim Her using more than his allotted time to talk to his players, considering they've been playing so well.
That's very surprising.
Very surprising.
I don't see how he can do anything but disturb. One game up, 11-4 up. Perhaps thinking ahead to hopefully later in this tournament from a Japanese perspective and tournament to come as well. And then it's a good thing to sort of give your players something to try and achieve and to focus on.
I can understand that theory in a first round where they're totally dominant. Yeah. But in a quarter final of a Super 1000, yeah. I think you just need to be focused on the moment of now.
That was also my thought, but trying to find an explanation that's the best I can come up with.
Yeah, okay. That's a wonderful smash again, so steep.
That's a beautiful. 14, I hope we get that in replay because look at the lift here, the elevation he gets. And it lands before Tui Yi, or at least where his shoes is.
Yeah. Well played by Teal. They're just so fast onto everything, the mid-court shots, the rear-court shots, anything loose at the net.
Thank you. Left back on the board, Tio.
So
back
quick
on the
board. In the perception of the game.
Every year, doesn't he?
Does. He does.
Have a good look.
Lovely to see.
15.
Oh, that's a good shot.
Over 16-7.
Yeah, found the gap. Fans haven't given up on them yet, and they shouldn't give up yet either. But one has to realise the time is running out for Ong and Teal.
A little bit by that right knee to
yeah.
The of course want to see the match through here on home soil.
Oh, what a sensational shot to bring up
20,
match point opportunities.
Eight.
That's an arrogant shot from Kobayashi. Wow.
He's faulted on the serve.
Service over. 9.
Too high,
20.
Says our service judge, Jakob Simberg of Denmark. This time, second time of asking, and a comprehensive victory by the former champions, Takuro Hoki and Yugo Kobayashi. 21-15, 21-9 against Ong Yu Sin and Tiu Yi. Only 34 minutes for the victory. And my goodness me, the Japanese
match
pair played well today.
Takuro Hoki and Yugo Kobayashi, 21-15, 21-9.
Confirmation, 21-15, 21-9. And the former champions, Hoki and Kobayashi, are safely through to the semi-final where they will meet last year's beaten finalists Liang Weikeng and Wang Chang. Welcome back to Kuala Lumpur. Quarterfinals day here at the PETRONAS Malaysia Open. Evening here in Kuala Lumpur, 8 p.m. in the evening.